It's like
we can differ no more.
We gather as a community of family and friends and feel ripples of excitement and tremors of joy as we celebrate the marriage of Michael and Amy. God has created a world of harmony, soaring birds, roaring ocean, brisk wind, and endless sand, each unique, each in relationship and harmony with the others. God's first gift was breathing life into humans and turning us toward each other to live in equality and unity. Michael and Amy have come here to affirm their love for each other and to enter their sacred union. Who presents this woman to be united in marriage to this man?
I do, her father.
Thank you. Marriage is a gift. Marriage is an opportunity for love to be learned. Marriage is a journey in which we as travelers are faced with many choices and responsible for these choices. Marriage is a call to servanthood. Marriage is a call to friendship. Marriage is a call to suffering. Marriage is not an event, but a way of life. Marriage involves intimacy in all areas for it to be fulfilling. Today, Michael and Amy, you have come together, bringing all of you to this marriage, all of the wonderful parts and all of your hurts and pains. You especially bring today all of your hopes and dreams for this marriage. You both have tremendous faith in each other as you trust your future in each other's care. You have excellent reasons for believing you belong together, but you have no guarantees. Instead, you stand together, about to accept on faith the challenge of creating the future together. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for. You marry in faith that God has called you to live as one. You promise to be faithful to one another in big things as well as small. Your constant faith in each other will give form and substance to the beautiful hope you have for your future. Faith is the conviction of things not seen. Unless you are an unusual couple, a time to marriage won't look like anything you vision and celebrate today. You may not feel much evidence of the love you now feel so keenly. At such a time, remember this moment. Remember the hopes and dreams that have been entrusted to your care. Marriage
that.
Begins with
no,
the
you cannot
equal
touch
faith that.
That
says I will.
You
before
can.
An unknown and unknown.
Do you see yourself?
Oh. Marriage is about being full
oh,
of faith
you are.
And faithful
come
to
here.
One another. Faithfulness
no, no, no.
Faithfulness is built from 10,000 years of trust and trustworthiness. In such faith, you will find the fulfillment of all the hopes and dreams you have today. May God bless you both. Amen. Michael and Amy, have you come here freely without reservation to join together lawfully in marriage? Before God and family and friends, I ask you to affirm your vows to each other as you enter into this new covenant of marriage and begin to share all the joys of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. Michael, do you take Amy to be your wedded wife, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to her for as long as you both shall live? Amy, do you take Michael to be your wedded husband, to live together in marriage? Do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to only him, for as long as you both shall live? May I have the rings? These rings are an outward and visible sign of an invisible truth. which binds two hearts in one. As such, they are symbols of the enduring, unending quality of the love which is not expressed between Michael and Amy. Michael, repeat after me. Amy?
Amy.
With this ring?
This ring.
I be with.
I be with.
Amy, repeat after me. Michael? Michael?
Michael.
With this ring? I be with. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day. And as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work along yours as together you build for a future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you throughout the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when you have fears or griefs and it fills your mind. These are the hands that will count endless, wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, like right now. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled in age, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Love is patient, love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Please join me in prayer to bless this marriage. God in heaven, you have ordained marriage for your children, and you gave us love. We present to you Michael and Amy, who have come to this day to be married. May the covenant of love they made be blessed with true devotion and spiritual commitment. We thank you for giving them strength and courage to keep their vows. Thank you for helping them to create for their family a peaceful, stable home of love and a foundation on which they can build their lives. When selfishness shows itself, grant generosity. When mistrust is a temptation, give moral strength. When there is misunderstanding, give patience and gentleness. When suffering becomes a part of their lives, give them a strong faith and abiding love. Amen. Michael and Amy, in the future, happy occasions will come surely as the morning. Difficult times will come surely as the night. To say the words, I love you, and compassion is being easy. But to accept that love and compassion are built upon patience and perseverance is not so easy. Michael and Amy, inasmuch as you have declared your willingness to enter the state of marriage with each other, and have declared the same in the company of God and these witnesses, by the virtue and authority vested in me by the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife, united in the pure and holy bond of wedlock. While God has joined, let no man separate. Go forth in this life as husband and wife, the blessings of God. Be loving, patient, and kind, and above all, forgive one another as God has forgiven you. It is my pleasure to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Michael Schloss. Michael and Amy would like to thank you for being present on their most special days. The bridal party will be taking pictures at this time, so immediate family should remain close for group photos. There is a cocktail hour and reception hour found immediately in the Horizon room. Thank you. And we are in the Horizon room. All right, there is a table assignment on the left side up here to the front. Please grab your name on the table assignment up here to my